unlock the door for us. Let's get on with it. The Dwemer of Nchardak appear to have been part of its control. Luckily, I found a view to operate it inside on my last visit. I sealed the door when I left to keep out ignorant meddlers. Let me unlock it. The book is just in time. So tantalizingly close. But trust me, no magic. I'd have had the book already, if it could. No, we'll have to do this the hard way. If we can restore the steam supply to this room, I'm certain I can open it. As you'll see, that's easier said than done. This way, to the boilers. I was here alone then, and I find an assistant is absolutely essential for this dirty, dangerous world. Nchardak, in 100 towers. In its day, it was the largest of the great Dwemer archives, and perhaps the most advanced. In the old days, it said the Dwemer submerged beneath the sea until the invaders gave up. I have my doubts, but the city was a marvel of Dwemer engineering, now reduced to this. As you can see, most of the lower levels of the city are flooded, but it isn't hopeless. The old Dwemer pumps still seem to work. Watch. But the pumps only operate when a cube is in the pit.
And fortunately,
I only have one cube. These four boilers provide steam to the room upstairs. They're shut down, but they still respond to the control cubes. So, turn these boilers back on and restore steam power to the room upstairs. Then I should be able to open the book's protective case. Bring that cube. We'll need it. Here we are. This device shows an emission of 4 volts. It looks like most of the... computers to be able to assemble a complete autonomy in a single day. Up from the Dwemer's army,